Well, hey there, folks, and welcome back once again to the Hop House. It's Eddy here, and it's time for another beer review. Do me a favour, if you've just discovered us, where have you been? Like, share, and subscribe to this video and this channel. It's the Hop House, hoppy beer, house music. We're on the beer side. Most of the channels have been on the beer side so far. Trying to sort out some live streaming stuff and upload. Well, not live streaming, sorry. I can't do that till I get to 1,000 subscribers. So come on, people, make it happen. But I'm trying to get a kit together so I can actually record some live mixes, and hopefully YouTube will let me stick them up. But I'm having some technical difficulties. I'm not the best technical wizard. Anyway, on with the beer review. So we just did the Four Pure Juice Box Citrus IPA. It got a thumbs up from me. It's quite nice. And we're carrying on. I'm a little bit excited for this one. It's not a bit virgin beer review. I have had it before. I've had it in a pub on keg when it first got released. But now it's canned and it's available on Morrisons. So this is available in your local Morrisons for £3 a can. I believe it's nationwide. It's certainly in the Midlands where I live anyway. Want to know what it is? Okay. It is this bad boy from Thornbridge Brewery. And if you go back to our Game Changer videos, of course, Jaipur, India Pale Ale, one of the first sort of really heavily American hopped IPAs that started off the sort of really citrusy, hoppy kind of craft beer movement, if you like, alongside Brewdog and a few others. But it's come up now to 15 years of Jaipur, and they did a few different versions of Jaipur of Thornbridge, and now they've released this into Morrisons in a 440ml can. DDH Jaipur from Thornbridge. I don't think you're going to get much from the light, but it does say Thornbridge there. It is also 5.9%, so it's the same strength as normal Jaipur. DDH, for those that don't know what that means, if you are a novice, it means it's double dry hopped Jaipur. The original Jaipur has been around since 2005. So last year, 2020, the year of endless struggles for everybody, the year of COVID, to celebrate 15 years, they brought this out. They brought a double Jaipur as well, or a Jaipur X, which is like a 10% version. Never seen that. I think if I had more than a pint and a half of that, I'd be on my arse. But this is the double dry hop version, 440ml can. Let's get it out into the glass and see what she looks like. So, normal Jaipur followed the old pattern of sort of West Coast style IPAs, where they put the hops in the boil kettle in the middle of the brew. This, they have double dry hopped it, so they've added some into the fermenter. So I'm guessing it's kind of going to be cloudy. What do you know it is? Sort of. That looks really good. Ooh. I'll whack it all in there. Give it a mammoth head. Right, so very sort of hazy New England style, actually. It's light. It's hazy. It's got a big white head on it. It's got a beautiful big white head on it, but it's sort of straw coloured between orange and yellow. It looks really good. Looks very sort of New England IPA-y. Have they added some oats to it as well to give it that sort of body? We'll find out. Yeah, that looks bob on. That does really look good. It looks like when you go abroad and you get a can of Fanta Orange. If you go abroad, it just seems a little lighter over there when you go to Spain. Fanta Naranja, they call it. Obviously it's got a big foamy white head on it. If you ignore the head for a minute, it looks a bit like a can of Fanta when you go to Spain. I like it, looks good. Right, we'll get the nose in there and we'll give it a whiff. See what we can sniff. Oh yeah. Smells very hoppy. Bit of sweetness actually compared to normal Jaipur. But I'm getting grapefruit. I'm getting bit of guava, definitely citrus, lemony, limey. Maybe some pithy peel. I don't know if that's like an orange peel or something. It smells like there's quite a bit of hops in there, but it doesn't smell pungently bitter. There's a little some, there's that underneath. Yeah, a bit of sweetness from the malt coming through as well. Have they added oats? I don't know. The head's sort of calmed down a bit now, but it still looks like Fanta in Spain. Right, we'll go ahead and try it. So bottoms up and down the old hatch. Whoa. That's actually a lot more bitter than I thought it was going to be. Whoa. Your eyebrows go like that. Whoa, yeah. Whoa. Wow. That's hoppy. It's citrusy and bitter as hell. It's wow. That's really something else. That is immense. To say I could smell some sweetness, not really a lot going on down the middle of the tongue, shooting down the sides, grapefruit, citrus, pithy, whoa. But, and I think this is to do with the dry hopping of it. Normal Jaipur, like your Oakham Citra and beers like that, American sort of sea hopped beers, at the end it'd just stay at the back of the tongue like there. This sort of mellows out. So it hits you with this raging sort of citrusy, hoppy bitterness. And then it sort of dries out. It goes to the back of the mouth and it just sort of peters out. So it doesn't dry out. It doesn't leave your mouth that dry. It gets the old taste buds going. And so I want more of it. Now, I did try this. I did try this on keg in my local pub. Remember when pubs were open? And they had it as part of their they do mainly hand pulls, you know, cask ales, but they'd usually have two lagers on and two sort of crafty beers, and they had this on. And I thought, well, it's Jaipur, I'll try it. And even the sort of manager of the pub said, you know, I think this will be up your street, Eddy. And I tried it. I was like, whoa. It's quite gassy though. Excuse me, that's disgusting. So I ended up having 2 pints of it, which probably wasn't that clever because I'd had a few pints beforehand. And I was already drinking another IPA at over 5%. It's only going on to this at 5.9. And put it this way, I was sort of stumbling home in a very good mood. Let's have a look and see what it says on the can. But that, you bob on. Very clever of Morrisons to be able to get hold of it as well. I think we are coming up to just past the middle of April, coming up towards the end of April. I think this has been in Morrisons stores for a couple of weeks. But with the Tesco range that came out, which I've not actually reviewed all of them. I need to start reviewing them. You know, the Vocation Tropical, they brought out a new Brewdog beer that's down there that I've got to put up on the channel. A new London Beer Factory I've got to put up on the channel, and some Northern Monk ones. There was a range, put it that way. So Morrisons last year in 2020, Tesco put out a range, and Morrisons a couple of weeks later just went bam. It was almost like tennis between the two of them, you know, back and forth. So this time around, Morrisons have brought this out, and they brought out Northern Monk's Mango with Faith, Mangoes on with Faith, or Faith with Mangoes, something like that. It's a take on their core Faith Hazy Pale Ale. And I've not seen much else new come out from Morrisons. So, a bit disappointing, I suppose, just from a craft beer fan point of view. But I think they've done well with this. They've done well to get this Jaipur double dry hop version. Right, read the can on the side. So a new beer, celebrate the 15th anniversary of Jaipur. Double dry hop Jaipur uses the same recipe, but it's double dry hopped, creating an even punchier tropical fruit character. That I'll agree with. That's really, whoa. So, hops. Good thing about Thornbridge, they do put the hops on there. I quite like that. So hops. Chinook, Centennial. I always call it a Huntum. I don't know how you pronounce that. Simcoe, Columbus, and Cascade. So there's four of the five C hops in there. Then you've got Atunum. It's actually the name of a Indian Native American tribe and a little sort of town. They obviously hop growers and Simcoe as well. So yes, there are 6 hops in this. 6 hops, which there are in the original Jaipur. I suppose you can argue over the actual quality of normal Jaipur these days. It used to be quite an expensive beer. You used to walk into a pub. Well, saying that, every time I've walked into a pub and it's been on cask, it has been sensational. I don't think the cask version has gone downhill, personally. But I know that people say that the bottled version, especially the canned versions, now that it's out there in every supermarket, it's more mass-produced. Has it gone down a peg or two? I still like it, but from what I've read on certain beer groups on Facebook and blogs and things like that, they're saying that this is more what the original Jaipur was like. So is it sort of a homage to the original Jaipur when it came out back in 2005? Can't say I drank it back in 2005. I'd have probably pulled a face like I did with the Oakham Citra if I did. So we have appearance light and hazy. Taste? Juicy pineapple, smell pomelo and tangerine. Food pairing ceviche. Did you see that with the food pairing, didn't you? With beer. I think this would be great. These kind of beers, so anything really that's hoppy and citrusy, that's got a bite to it. Oh yeah, that smells lovely. Anything that's got a bite to it, I think goes well with either a strong blue cheese, it's the flavours that work, so a Stilton or Black Sticks Blue or Shropshire Blue is really quite nice, local to me. It's more orangey than yellow with the blue bits in, but it's a little bit milder, so it's a bit creamier. So a really strong sort of blue cheese or crisp-wise, sort of the chilli one, so you swipe Thai sweet chilli. The ones from Tyrrell's are really good. The sweet chilli and red pepper, they're amazing. Lidl, how they don't do their own anymore that I've been to recently, but Lidl do their own version of sweet chilli and sour cream. That with this, really, really good. So it's that kind of sweet chilli crisps, a bit of a spice on it, a bit of sweetness. Goes really well with something hoppy like this. That's your food pairing from Eddy, please. Or a strong blue cheese. Right. My verdict, my rating, what we're going to say. That is amazing. That's really good. It's been a few months since I had it on keg. I was a little bit in love with it when I had it on keg. And I inside 2 pints of it. But I think it knocked me a bit for 6 because of the strength. Because of what I'd drunk previously. But that, 2 thumbs up from me. Is Bob On. Really good. Right up my street. Absolutely fantastic. So 2 thumbs up. Thank you very much. Like, share and subscribe to the channel. And we'll see you next time on the Hop House. Ciao for now, people.